This is Adjuster TV, Adjusters First. This video is sponsored by Hague Education. Use code ADJUSTERTV to get a 15% discount on damage assessment, CE training, industry certifications, books, and tools at hagueeducation.com. And by Kaplik. Learn all about E&O and other insurance for adjusters at cplic.net/adjustertv. And by the multinational IA firm Crawford & Company. To be the best, you have to join the best at crawco.com/cat.
I was confused by the claim examiner role, which I know you had mentioned in one of your videos that there's either a beginner does those or somebody who's been in the industry for a long time does those. So I'm curious about that role that I'm looking into.
Sure.
As a salaried role. And I'm like, is that cheating to skip, to start there and I'm not going to get the skills of adjuster, or is that a good, could that be a good place to start, or am I going to look back and regret that I started there and I should have started somewhere else, to take that if I'm offered that.
Right. So it kind of boils down to what opportunities are available when you're ready to go work. Right. So if there's a hurricane, a lot of times that's when people are like, well, I can go to Home Depot and buy a ladder and go do that. Right. But if this is January or it's April and it's nothing's going on, and you're ready to get started, then that's when you take you look at what's available and you say, all right, I'm going to jump on that. I don't think that there's any particular role that an independent adjuster does that's permanent, right? Okay. Even at like the corporate level at these IA firms, people are moving around all the time, right? You might have a manager over at this firm and then, run claims with them for a while and then go run claims from somebody else and then have the same person be your manager again because they switched over, right? Or they're back out in the field, or people that you were in trainings with are now, that guy's your manager now, right? Because he decided you can do all kinds of things.
Which is weird because in so many other industries, you don't really talk about, where what other company you're moving to. And so I think a lot of people get a little bit of apprehensive about, and I think I asked you that one of my questions. It's like, is it okay if I am filling out this stuff, on this roster, but I'm and onboarding paperwork and going through the background checks and drug screens all that for this one, but then I'm also talking to this one, It's weird for some of us because in so many industries you don't really, it's all hush hush. And so it's kind of cool and different and interesting, but we have to know, I guess they're used to that. It's fine.
Yep. It's a unique industry. And I would say that the firms, their ideal scenario is that people are loyal to them and they only go work for this particular company. Right. So if I run an IA firm and I know that you do great work, I don't want to call you and have you be like, oh, sorry, I can't, I'm working with somebody else. I don't want that, but I understand that that's the reality. I didn't have anything for you and you found another opportunity someplace else. Great. Just, okay, cool. Well, no worries. Just let me know when you're done and maybe we'll still have something for you to do over here. Right. That's the kind of conversation that you'll have. If you go to the conferences and things like that, I mean, especially NACA, there's 60 IA firms there and everybody knows everybody. And they worked at, you can go to two or three NACA conferences in a row and it's like a snow globe, right? You shake it up each time and wherever the snow falls, that's where everybody kind of moved around to. And it's like, so-and-so was sitting at the pilot booth that time. Now this year they're sitting at the Sedgwick booth and vice versa. And it's like, so everybody's like, and they all go out to dinner with each other and they talk about who's a really great adjuster or who's not so great. It's I think it's more important that you do the best job you can for whoever you're working for. And the carriers are gonna notice as well, right? So if you go work for Big Red they use, from what I know, at least a half a dozen IA firms, the big IA firms, probably more than that, right? If you go work for IA firm A and you go to run claims for, you know, the big farm guys, and you mess it all up and you're terrible customer service and it's nothing but complaints, and you get let go, and then you try to go over here to IA firm B and try to run claims for State Farm's, you're already on their list, right? So it doesn't matter where you go, you're going to be blocked or welcomed in, right? Oh, we know that so-and-so, we know that Carrie does a great job and we're happy to have, you know, you're going to run into the same managers and like State Farm managers or whatever.
Right.
So it's not really so much like you have to be secretive about anything because they know. And in the beginning, you're going to have to cast a wide net, right? You're going to have to be, get on as many rosters as you can, go attend as many training things, as many of their networking events, as many, you know, if they offer carrier certifications or trainings, go and take those, like as much as you can, and meet people, you know, go up after class and talk to them. And if they have like a, you know, a happy hour thing afterwards, go to that. Because you want to, you want to network with these people, right?
Adjuster TV, when you know, you know.